Thought it would be easier just to do a quick video to show you how to handle this embedded HTML content that's inside the RESX file. So I've recreated your RESX file like this. So I've just added a little header so it gets picked up properly by Studio. And you can see I've got all your embedded content. You see all this HTML code here that's written inside the value element. So all I'm going to do, if I try and translate that file as it is, when you open it up, I get exactly the problem you have. Everything's in one segment, and I can see I'm getting the embedded content extracted as translatable content, which is not what I want. So all I'm going to do is edit that rule by going to File, Options. You can see I've already been there, but basically you come into the file types here, scroll down, and the one you want is the XML Microsoft.net resources. You can see the dialog expression it's picking up is RESX files. If you pick up the parser rules, click on the parser node, this gives you all the rules that have been created for this particular file. Now, because this is content that's inside the value, I probably gave you a bit of a bum steer when I said just add a new rule. You don't actually need to add a new rule as such, you just need to refine one that's here. And by refining, I mean you need to help it to handle the embedded content. So to do that, we need to enable the embedded content processor. So when you do this, you check on process embedded content using the following processor. Pick the one you want. It doesn't really matter. It could be HTML 4 or 5. I'll use 5, that would be fine. It's not C data, but we're going to use document structure. Now the way this works, if I go back to the parser rule, you can see that this element down here, the data value, this is the one that's actually extracting all the translatable content in the value element. And that's been given some structure already. The structure has been given as a paragraph type. So all I need to do is tell the embedded content processor to use the HTML filter whenever it comes across this paragraph type. So I click back on here again. Now that I've enabled it, I click on add. I hit the drop down, come down to paragraph, and say okay. So that's it. So now I've said, whenever you've come across paragraph document structure, use the HTML embedded content. And in this case, the only one that it applies to is the data value, which is exactly the one we want for your file. So when I translate the file now, you can see it processes it exactly as you'd like. You can also see, because I'm using tag ID mode, which if you didn't know, it's this little item up here. So you can see when I change to these different types of tags, it changes the size of the orange tab down here. Tag ID tells you which file type has been used. So I just tend to leave it in there because I quite like being able to make sure that I've been using the right file type. So you can see that the overriding file is the XML RESX file type, but inside that it's used the HTML embedded content file for all the content inside there that contain the embedded content. And that's what you want, nice and easy. It's even giving you the information that it's a list item, which is what LI was for. Hope that was helpful.